Hello everyone, I'm Surbhi, Assistant Professor in the Department of ICT and Training Division at CIT NCRT. Today, we will be discussing on the integration of ICT in teaching, learning and assessment. Let me start with the introduction of the panelist. We have with us Professor Indu Kumar, who is the head of Department of ICT and Training Division. She is joined by Dr. Mahmood Ali, who is Assistant Professor at the Department of ICT and Training Division.
Thank you.
As we all know, within a very short span of time, ICT has become one of the basic building blocks of the modern society. Nowadays, understanding of ICT and its basic skills has become part of the core of education. But still, different people have different meaning of ICT. So, I would like to ask Professor Indu Kumar, what do you mean by ICT when it comes to integration of ICT in the teaching learning process?
It's a very basic question when it comes to education. So what do we mean by integration of ICT in education, and for that matter, what is ICT? So all those possibilities which makes it possible to create digital information, to store the digital information, to retrieve that created digital information, and also exchange information, using all these technologies, all these things for educational purposes, is ICT in education. That means creating digital information, storing digital information, retrieving when it is required, sharing and exchanging information is with each other using technological possibilities is ICT in education. For example, there are a lot of messaging and content sharing tools which we use as a social media tool. So it makes it possible to create information, share information, retrieve information, exchange information. And when it comes to devices, smartphone is device for an example. We can create any digital information, like we can click a photograph, we can store it in the gallery. Later on, whenever we require it, we can retrieve it, we can also edit it. And if it is an educational content, we can exchange it with our fellow teachers. We can use it for teaching learning purposes within the class with our students. So there are a lot of such technologies which make it possible to integrating ICT or education technology in education. I hope I answered your question, and if Dr. Mahmood wants to add something to it, he can also add something to this question.
I think you have mentioned very well that ICT means the focus of the meaning of ICT may be related with the educational process, as we know that in education the content and the communication or interaction with the student is very important. Similarly, in ICT, creating information and communicating information is important. So these two common features are there which interconnect ICT and education. So we can think in that way also. And other than that you have already mentioned that ICT will maybe understood by the functions which are mentioned by you, like creating, storing, retrieving and communicating digital information with the use of such technologies. I think so.
Thank you, Professor Indu Kumar, for such a detailed explanation, and thank you, Dr. Mahmood Ali, for adding on to it. It is a well-known fact that no two individuals are alike. Every person has different learning styles. So, I would like to ask Dr. Mahmood Ali, how is ICT related to multi-sensory approach of learning?
Yes. As we all know that all the learners or children, if you talk about, already you have mentioned that every individual is different in terms of learning style. So if a child is learning with the visuals, ICT has this potential to provide resources or opportunities in terms of visual resources to learn the content or to make them understand the content in that way or that medium which they want to learn. Similarly, there are so many children which are learning with the use of auditory, you can say, senses, or in terms of the resources which are provided in terms of audio resource. Similarly, there are different type of learning styles. Similarly to audio, auditory and visual, there are kinesthetic learners and there are tactile learners. So ICT has potential to provide them resources for their learning style to facilitate their learning process. So this way we can say that ICT is facilitating the learning process by providing learning resources as per the need of the learner in terms of learning style.
Thank you, Dr. Mamur Ali. Now, the teacher has understood the meaning of ICT and he or she wants to integrate that into his or her classroom. So, I would like to ask Dr. Indu Kumar, what is the practical way to integrate ICT in teaching learning process?
So, when we want to integrate ICT or technological resources into the teaching learning process, we need to take care of a lot of consideration. First of all, we need to analyze the content, to what content we are going to teach. So the content should be suitable to integrate certain kind of technologies. If the content doesn't require any technology, it is not a compulsion to deliberately integrate ICT or technological resources. For this, analyzing the content, the nature of content, it is very, very important. Because sometimes there are such content which are best explained by chalk and board or by verbal communication. But whenever there is such content, we need certain kind of media interventions, like some abstract content, which cannot be made clear by verbal explanation. Then comes the role of media, or then comes the role of technology. Then we need to analyze what kind of technological resource we need to integrate at that particular spot for the better conceptual clarity of the content we are dealing with. And then we also need to take care of the context of the learner. As you know, India is a diverse country, so geographically it is diverse. It is diverse in terms of socio-economic background of the learner. Culturally also we are different. We can understand certain kind of content to which we are exposed to, but the concepts we are not exposed to practically is very, very difficult for us to comprehend. So that is why we need to understand the context. And when I am talking about context, I am also talking about the ICT facilities, because there is diversity in terms of availability of ICT facilities also. If there is no ICT infrastructure, then also there is possibility of integrating ICT, because every teacher in our country having smartphones. So smartphone also poses a lot of possibilities by which we can integrate ICT in teaching learning process. There are a lot of educational apps which are available by which we can make teaching learning process more interesting, more comprehensible for the learner. Then the third aspect which we need to take care of is pedagogy. As there are different learning style, which Mamur already mentioned here, there are also different pedagogical styles of different teachers. Some teachers are comfortable in using project method. Some teachers are best can explain a concept by showing a movie and then explaining it. Some are using, can also use flipped learning. By flipped learning, I mean we can share resources with the learners, and later on, the classroom environment we can utilize for having discussion with the students, so that we can also hear the voices of teachers. So that is how we can consider the our pedagogical style when we want to integrate ICT. And then the fourth parameter for integrating ICT, fourth consideration for integrating ICT, is about the knowledge of technology. What are technologies which are available in our context in which we are teaching? So we have to identify those technologies. There are a lot of repositories available. If we have access to all those repositories, we can make use of it. Or if we simply have a smartphone, so that smartphone technology can be explored to better explain a certain concept to make teaching learning better. So that is how we can take consideration of these four parameters: content, context, then pedagogy, and the availability of technologies, and integrate them accordingly.
Thank you, Dr. Indu Kumar, for briefly explaining us all the four different parameters that we need to consider while integrating ICT in the teaching learning process. I would like to ask Dr. Mamur Ali, how does the nature of content affect the choice of ICT or the media that is to be used in the classroom?
As we all know, the teacher and the students, whenever we are talking about ICT integration, and we are first, as Dr. Indu Kumar already mentioned, that we have, or we are talking about four parameters. The very first parameter is the content, the nature of the content. So as we understand that every subject has a different nature, similarly, even in the subject or in the a particular discipline, the content itself is having a different nature. So if the content is having different nature, as per the nature, ICT may be selected. I can give you here one example. Sometime the content is factual, means we are talking about a fact. Sometimes the content may be procedural, means the procedure is involved which a child has to understand. So as per the nature, if the content is factual, there may be ICT or the resource which is simply an image or presentation or digital poster to display or to present the content. But whenever you are talking about a procedural content and you want to make the child understand that these are the steps and this is the procedural, you can say, way, then you have to have some kind of video or simulation or some kind of interactive material which may involve or engage the child to understand this procedural aspect. So as per the nature of the content, we have to think about the ICT. So content may have different nature, like factual, procedural, metacognitive element may be there, or it may be conceptual. So as per the nature, we have to select ICT. Yes.
So now we all know that as per the nature of the content, ICT tools should be selected. Now that we have understood the importance of content analysis, let me ask Professor Indu Kumar, can you explain the importance of context in the integration of ICT?
The understanding the whole scenario, the context of the learner as well as the teacher, is very, very important. So there are demographical considerations also when we talk about context. The demography of the learner or teacher is such, as I already mentioned, that there is no ICT tools or ICT facilities available there. So they have to look at the whole context, the whole scenario, before identifying a particular ICT, possibility, integration of ICT possibility. Like that, we can also understand what all the learners are exposed to if they are residing in a particular geographical locations. We cannot use internet if internet is not reaching a particular geographical location. So we have to look for offline ICT resources there at that place. And also there are learners who have some kind of special needs. So their needs need to be catered to by using or selecting suitable ICTs. There are learners who cannot see or who are deaf and mute. So the technologies which best cater to all such children with special needs also builds their context. So audiobook or using audio resources is suitable to the learner who cannot read, who are visually challenged, who are visually impaired. And using a lot of visual stimulus to children who cannot hear is very, very important. So like that, we can analyze the context in terms of availability of technology and in terms of the learners we are dealing with, and also the kind of teacher we are. We also have to analyze our ICT competencies, and in the given context, we have to enhance our skills and abilities for making learning comprehensible, for making learning interesting for the learners we are dealing with.
So, as rightly told by Professor Indu Kumar, context analysis is also very important when we have to integrate ICT into our classrooms. So, if we talk about classroom scenario, how does ICT and teaching learning method related? This question is posed for Dr. Mamur Ali.
Okay, before responding to this question, I would like to inform our viewers that whenever the training program will be conducted, the resource person will give you more details and more examples on these parameters, as well as whenever you will go through the module, you will get all the details related to these parameters. But we are now talking about the third parameter, which is related to teaching learning methods. So as we are discussing from nature of content to context and then teaching of methods, all these are interrelated. Whenever we are thinking about a nature of the content and found that, for example, the content is having the procedural nature, then we are saying that we will select a particular type of resource, or you can say ICT. Similarly, when you are talking about a content which is procedural, you will select a method. Like, for example, if I want to make the child understand the difference between metals and non-metals, maybe a teacher can use activity method to give them activity to differentiate between the metals and non-metals. So for that purpose, ICT may be chosen, or you can say the ICT may be selected to first project or to present the, you can say, images or the objects in front of the child in terms of digital resources. And then there may be some interactive built with the help of some software, like we are using H5P nowadays, or there are so many other software, or you can say technologies, which can create interactives to give them opportunity to differentiate between the objects virtually. So there are so many technologies or ICTs which can be associated or linked with the teaching learning methods. So similarly, there are so many other examples. Whatever we are telling here, it is suggestive. So whenever you will go through the module, you will get more details, as well as the resource person in the training program will give you more examples to make you understand what is the connection between ICT and teaching learning method, and how we can select ICT on the basis of teaching learning method.
So I would like to add something here. Like, for example, when we are a teacher is making a lesson planning for his or her teaching. So there is different ways of integrating ICT in their plan, which they are making, which they are chalking out for the children. Like, we can integrate technology pre-lesson, like I talked about flipped learning, share resources earlier, and then they come to class seeing all those resources, studying all those resources, and make use of classroom environment discussing with each other or discussing with teachers. So that is how we can integrate technology pre-lesson and during the lesson. So there are mid-lesson uses of technologies also. If we want to show video program, or we want to make children listen to some audio, we can integrate wherever the context come during the lesson. We can integrate that particular resource mid-lesson. And there are a lot of assessment tools also, by which technologies also, by which we can H5P, Dr. Mamur already mentioned, by using this H5P software, we can create beautiful quizzes, pictorial quizzes. We can create educational games by which, by playing those games, children can make assessment of their learning, and also teacher can use them to assess the learning of the learners. So like that, we can integrate ICT pre-lesson, mid-lesson, and post-lesson. or wherever we feel like to enhance learning.
The teachers who are using web portal nista.ncrt.gov.in, they can also use mobile app and they can access the resources even offline. So these are the two things which are technology, you can say, supported facilities are there to conduct and to monitor these training activities.
So with this, we will close the panel discussion for today. Hope you liked it and got a clearer picture of how to integrate ICT in teaching, learning and assessment. For more information, you can access the resources which are given in the module and on the platform. Thank you, Professor Indu Kumar. Thank you, Dr. Mamurali. Thank you.